channel. For today's video, I'm sharing an Indian festive wedding guest makeup tutorial with you all. It's of course the makeup I'm wearing right now. So all of this makeup on my face right now is super affordable makeup, and not just that, it's affordable but great makeup. Everything I'm using in this video is under 500 rupees. At the same time, all of this makeup is like some of my favorites at the drugstore. Like if you use this makeup and like wear this makeup to like a wedding or even like to your Navratri Garba or anything like that, you're not going to like end up with a smudged face of makeup. This makeup is going to stay put. It's going to be very long lasting. With all the techniques that I use in today's video, you have to make sure to like follow them to the T, but you will have like a long lasting face of makeup, but at the same time like super beautiful even at the end of the day. Let's dive right into the makeup. But before that, if you're seeing my beautiful face for the first time on the internet, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make honest, inclusive beauty content here on YouTube. So make sure that you hit the subscribe button if you're interested in that sort of content, and also click on the bell icon right next to it so that you're notified every Thursday and Sunday when I upload a new video. Now if you're interested to know how I got this look, then please keep on watching. Let's get started. Of course, we have to start with skincare and skin prep. I always emphasize this. Do not apply your makeup bare face without any skincare, because it's going to react with your skin. Of course, makeup has a lot of chemicals and it's going to not be the best for your skin, especially when you're going to wear it for so long. So the first step in my skincare routine, of course, is washing my face. I use the Dermaviv Hydra Cleanser to cleanse my face. I was actually experimenting with my makeup right now and doing something for Instagram, so I took everything off with this cleanser just before I sat to film this. And this cleanser just takes away all of like the excess makeup and the glitter and all of that I had going on. And next step, I go in directly with a moisturizer. When I'm applying makeup, I don't really take the effort to go into the depths and do like serum and like everything else. The only two steps I really make sure I'm doing is sunscreen and moisturizer. But right now I'm just like filming from home, so I'm not really applying sunscreen. If you're wearing this makeup and going out anywhere, make sure that you're applying sunscreen after your moisturizer. So this is step number two. I'm using the Nutriderm Vitamin E Moisturizing Lotion. Really great base for your makeup. It's a very nice and like a heavy-ish moisturizer. It's not too heavy, it's not too light that it's like really not doing anything for your skin, but it's also not like too heavy to the point that you feel you can like feel it underneath your makeup. So it's just the right texture and it really hydrates my skin so beautifully underneath all that makeup. I really prefer this. I literally only use this moisturizer when I'm applying makeup. I don't reach out for anything else. Starting with makeup, the first step is primer. Of course, this just helps your makeup last longer. I'm using the Lakme Absolute Blur Perfect Makeup Primer. This is a really great makeup base, very affordable, but at the same time, the texture of this primer is so great that it just blurs out everything. Like, can you see how it just fills in your pores? Just take a little bit of the product and press it in your skin. Make sure that you're like concentrating it, especially the area that you're very oily and you tend to like have like larger pores, which will make you sweat a lot and then just make your makeup very messy at the end of the day. So just press in product in those areas, in my fine lines where my makeup tends to like go away, and just dab it into your skin. This step is important, especially if you like complain mostly that your makeup doesn't last very long. If you do this, your makeup is going to last the entire night. Next, diving straight into foundation, and this is the first time I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me foundation. I can't really tell you how this foundation is, but I know it's a cult favorite. I literally have the price tag on till now because I just purchased it on popular request. Everyone was asking me to purchase the Maybelline Fit Me because the shade that I used to use like back in the day when I started makeup was the shade 322 Warm Honey, and if I'm not mistaken, they have discontinued that shade now. So I went ahead to buy myself the shade 330 Toffee, and I wanted to see if this is now the perfect match, because this looks much lighter than what Toffee looked before, and in the bottle it looks perfect. So I'm just going to take a little bit on the back of my hand. Since this is like festive makeup, I like to go like all glam. And this foundation is fairly medium to full coverage, and it's at a great price as well, so it's great if you're just starting into makeup. Okay, taking a little bit on my hand, I'm just going to dot this foundation equally everywhere on my face so I have an even application. Next, I'm taking my beauty sponge. This is by the company Plume & Co. Really affordable beauty sponge. This sponge is really, really great. It's a great price as well as the texture. The feel of the sponge is amazing. Blends your makeup really well. And I'm just going to bounce the product in my skin. Make sure that you're bouncing your foundation and not like tugging at your skin and like pulling and displacing foundation from one place to the other. And go over your entire face as well as your neck. The foundation match is actually pretty damn great. It's pretty precise. I don't know if I have gotten tanner. I don't think I have. I just think they have reformulated their foundation shades. I mean, if they've discontinued one, they must have possibly made the other one lighter or something. Just let me know in the comments if you were 322 warm honey, is 330 toffee suiting you right now? I mean, of course I haven't gotten darker because I'm literally sitting indoors all the time, so that's not possible. All my other foundations are looking much darker on me right now. Next, I'm going in with concealer. I'm using the Wet n Wild color corrector and concealer in the shade medium. Medium deep tan. I've always, like everybody always asks if I'm medium something else or medium something else. I didn't know they had two medium shades. Now when you take concealer, this is also a very affordable and great concealer. It's actually one of my favorites. Just take like a little bit. If you have like serious dark circles, make sure you're like really covering your dark circles well. I also like to go over my eyes because this acts as a great primer for my eyeshadow game. So when I'm applying eyeshadow, the eyeshadow will just stay on longer and stick better and look better with the concealer on. This concealer is more of a medium to medium coverage, not full. So if you have like serious dark circle issues, you should try the PAC Spotlight Concealer. That's like full coverage. Then I go over the bridge of my nose because this works really well to highlight my face. And then on my forehead area and just a little bit over here to cut like my cheekbones. And then a little bit over here above my Cupid's bow. And that's that. So this is mostly the areas I like to conceal. Going in with the same sponge, just blend. Be very careful around your eye area. Do not tug. You will give rise to a lot of wrinkles. Be careful. Just press the product on your skin. I had applied lip balm before, but I'm just going to take the Body Shop lip balm once again. This is in the strawberry variant. This is because I don't like foundation on my lips. I've become very finicky about that. It makes my lips super, super dry. And I'm also having like a sort of pigmentation going on my lips right now. So that's why I like to keep them moisturized and hydrated at all times. Okay, I'm just gonna set all of this in place and I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. This is in the shade Medium Moyen. I personally prefer loose powders over like compact powders. I know compact powders are the very Indian thing because Indian women are obsessed with compact powders, so was I back in the day. But now that loose powders are really picking up the trend, and I have been using loose powders since forever, and I cannot seem to go back to compact powders. So just take a little bit and like dust it all over your face. Compact powders are great to like blot and you know, like touch up your makeup. You can always have them in your purse to touch up your makeup. But to set your face initially, I really prefer a loose powder. Just taking a little bit and like pressing it into my skin. This is actually a really great loose powder. It's not great for baking though because it can be super drying and does not really set your face very well and looks very you can see that you have powder on your face if you use this for baking. I'm just gonna leave my base as is and I'm gonna do my eyes next, so I'll zoom you guys in for that. Perfect, so diving into eyeshadow, I'm using the Nykaa K eyeshadow palette. This is in the shade Poison Apple. I've used this palette on my channel before in my Gossip and Get Ready with Me, and that was the first time I tried it out. I really do like this palette. The only thing I don't like about this palette is like the color combination. I mean, I love these colors specifically, but I really wish there was some brown happening over here or something. You know, you don't really need so many shimmers. So I do need a brown base as a transition color before I dive into these bright colors. So for that, I'm just going to use my bronzer. This is the Savannah Colors bronzer, and I'm going to take this dark shade and this loose brush. This is the pack 311, and I'm just going to take this. Taking that bronzer shade, I'm just going to put it like as a transition base color. By the way, I'm wearing a blue top, like a blue choli, but The dupatta I have with this is like a nice bright pink, which is why I'm going in for the poison apple palette. This is a great trick to do if you don't have a brown eyeshadow. Just take your bronzer and like buff it very well in your crease and on your lid, or vice versa. If you don't have a great bronzer, just use your brown eyeshadow as a bronzer. Next, I'm going to take this bright pink vermilion sort of a color. These shadows are really pigmented. I'm going to take it on the same brush because I don't want too much pigment to show up. So I'm just going to loosely put this in my crease, a little lower than where that brown went. Taking little product and then blending and building over it is always a great trick, because when you're playing with colors, if you overdo it, there is no way to go back. But if you like just take a little bit and then build it from there, it looks beautiful and looks very well blended. Okay, now that I have this shade going on, I'm going to take this deep purplish sort of color, and I'm just going to like press this dense packing brush. This is a pack 203 brush. I'm taking this color over here and I'm going to pack this on the outer corner just to add more dimension and depth to this whole look. Just going in circular motions because I only want this color in this area. Alright, so for the main sparkly element in this whole festive look, I'm going to take the Swiss Beauty Glitter Liquid Shadow. This is in the shade 03 Champagne, and I'm just going to take this directly on my eyes. After doing that, I'm just going to go ahead with this flat brush and make sure it's like properly blended. Going back with the packing brush, packing some eyeshadow over the glitter so that the glitter doesn't look very obvious, and just packing, blending, making sure everything is seamlessly blended into each other. So just with my finger, I'm like gonna press the liquid shadow away so it gives like a seamless blend on my entire eye. Going back into the Nykaa K palette, and I'm taking the shimmer shade on a pack 202 brush. This is like a small packing brush, and I'm just gonna pack some shimmer on the inner corner of my eye. What this will do is just open up your eyes and look like really sparkly, blingy, but at the same time like make your eyes look a lot like more open. So just place it near your inner tear duct and blend it in your shadow. And do the same thing for your eyebrows, just on the arch of your brow. Don't pull it down too much because that will just make your eyes look more droopy. Just to raise your eyes, like adding highlights and accents to your face, just put it on the arch of the brow. Taking the K by Katrina Kajal. This is a great kohl and kajal if you're on a budget, because it's super pigmented and glides very easily on the eyes. So I'm just gonna lay this on my waterline, as well as gonna tight line with this. Now going back into the palette, I'm taking this flat brush. This is not a branded brush, so it's just like a flat small brush, and I'm gonna take this darker color which we put on our outer corner. So we basically just played around with these two shades to get this eye and that Swiss Beauty palette, and this dark color now I'm gonna lay it on my lower lash line. So very precisely I'm going, because I don't want a very smoky lower lash. What this will do is just like tie your entire look together really well. Just putting eyeshadow on your top lid and not putting anything on the lower lash looks very incomplete. So I'm just placing it, and then I'm gonna smoke it out with another color. And now I'm taking this e.l.f. crease brush, which is like a buffing brush, and I'm going to take this lighter color which we put in our crease, and I'm just going to smoke out the lower lash line further. So since I went very precise with the previous shade, this one will just help me blend it all in. Now for eyeliner, I'm using the Lakme Absolute eyeliner. This is literally my favorite eyeliner. I only use this eyeliner. I literally don't use anything else. Whenever I try like even a high-end eyeliner, I'm so disappointed. And this is great if you're on a budget. Even if you're not on a budget, you should try this one. I'm going to draw a winged liner. I've not done one in very long, so I need to practice once again. I will leave a link to my winged eyeliner tutorial right here or here, wherever. And you can watch that if you want like an in-depth tutorial on how I do my winged liner. Next step is mascara, and I'm using the Essence Lash Princess mascara. This is sadly unavailable everywhere right now. Like, this is the only product I'm using, which it's difficult to get your hands on this. I do get mine internationally, but now I've realized that it's not there even in the international markets. So I'm just gonna quickly coat my lashes with this. I really like this mascara. I don't know, Essence, if you're watching this, please bring this back. What is your problem? Like, why would you do that to us? This is such a great mascara, and Essence is so affordable. Now you can very well leave your eye look just like this. You don't have to add anything extra to this. Of course, I have to do my eyebrows yet. I'm gonna do that, of course, on camera. But before that, I would like to add falsies, because I feel like falsies just changes your makeup game, especially when it's like so elaborate eye makeup. It just looks so much better and like fluttery and nice. So I'm gonna use the Glomier Beauty false lashes. The name is not on this package for some reason, but these are not in any way affordable lashes. If you're looking for affordable lashes, Pro Art and Pack make really great affordable lashes. They are mostly like use and throw. You can use it once or twice or thrice and then throw them, but I like to use my lashes very many times, and these are great for that. They are expensive, but they last me. I have lashes for over two to three years from them, and I keep cleaning the lash band and reusing them, so they are great quality if you're looking for something more permanent. I'm gonna put these on and be right back. If you want a tutorial on how to put your lashes, I'm gonna link it here. Go watch that and I will be right back. Alright, so my lashes are now on, and I'm going to do my eyebrows next. And for that, I'm using the Miss Claire Eyebrow Pencil. I use it in the shade 06 Coffee Brown. It's a perfect like ashy brown color. And Miss Claire Eyebrow Pencils are perfect. They're so amazing. And like, I mean, why do you really have to spend so much on brow products when you can get Miss Claire at such a cheap price? So I'm just going to like fill my brow hairs in. I like to go in first on the top layer. Draw a straight line, like flick my brow pencil, fill all the hairs, and then go on the arch, and then go downwards, flick downwards, and then just fill it in. You can also raise your eyebrows if you want to like define the lower brow line. I'm satisfied with how it's filled. So this comes with a spoolie. I'm just gonna put the cap on and like take this spoolie brush thing on top and like flick all the brow hairs on top and give like that bushy appearance first, blending the product on top first, and then just take it like this and swipe across. So that's how you get like the perfect brow. Let's continue with the face makeup now. So first I'm going to use a bronzer to like add some warmth to my face. I'm using the Sivana Colors Bronze Professional Bronzer. This is in the shade 04. And I'm going to take like a mix of this warm shimmery shade and this darker color. And I'm just taking this on the pack 214 brush. And I'm just going to chisel out my cheekbones, carve out my jawline with this. Just place this in the areas that you want shadows to form. So basically it will just make your face look more chiseled. This color is having a little bit of a gray undertone, so it works perfectly as a contour cum bronzer. Alright, next step is blush. I'm taking the LA Colors Red Rouge Blush. This is in the shade Awesome. And I'm taking the e.l.f. Stippling Brush. This is a great cool toned mauvey pink shade. I'm just going to place this on the apples of my cheek, stippling it in place. I'm not adding too much blush because there's already a lot happening on my eyes like color wise. So I'm just going to tone it down with the blush. Mm-hmm. Next, I'm taking the Maybelline Master Chrome Highlight. This is in the shade Molten Gold. And I'm just going to place this on the top of my cheekbone to add a lot of like bling and highlight to my look. Of course, very essential for like a festive makeup look. Place it also on like the bridge of your nose and your cupid's bow. Taking the makeup fixing spray, I'm gonna like shake the bottle and like spritz it all over. And then I'm gonna take like my beauty sponge and pick up any excess product on my face. This is a great step to do if you have any excess like concealer, foundation, powder, highlight, anything. The makeup sponge is just gonna pick it right up. So, and also set your makeup in place for a really, really long time. We are almost done with our makeup look. The final step is lipstick, and I'm using the Miss Claire Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade 42. I want something a little darker than this. Like, I wanted something more blood red. This is more in the vermilion tone, so I'm gonna like take the shade 61. This is more like a deep crimson color. Yeah, this is much like it. And that's it. With that, we finished our makeup look. I'm just gonna add some jewelry and drape my dupatta and be right back. I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup tutorial with me. I used all of the products which were very affordable. Almost all are like under 500 products, and all of these are like great makeup products. Nothing like because it's like inexpensive, it's not good. It's great makeup. I love using this makeup literally. Even if I didn't have like high-end makeup, I would use this and go to the wedding. It's more about the techniques, so make sure that you're following like the tutorial techniques to the T to be able to have a makeup that is long-lasting and also beautiful at the same time. If you did actually like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button so it helps with the YouTube algorithm in general. I will make sure to link all of these products in the description box for you. For today's video, the Sara Squad shoutout goes to Dr. Sneha Haridas. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shoutout, then all you have to do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you'll get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shoutout. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, stay home, stay safe, and I love you. Mwah.